Channel 2, WBBM-TV, Chicago. Walter Jacobson, Don Craig, Harry Volkman, and Johnny Morris with Chicago's number one news. Channel 2, the 10 o'clock news.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Don and Walter have the night off. Carol Krause and I are sitting in. And tonight, the waiting is over for newsman Dan Rather. A jury in Los Angeles has decided that Rather and CBS News did not slander a doctor during an episode of 60 Minutes. The verdict came after 10 hours of deliberation spread out over 3 days. A Los Angeles doctor, Carl Galloway, had accused Rather of defaming him in a 60-minute report on insurance fraud. But the jury said there was no evidence that Rather showed a reckless disregard for the truth.
We, the jury, in the above entitled action, find four defendants, CBS Incorporated, Dan Rather, and Stephen Glauber, and against the plaintiff, Carl A. Galloway, M.D.
CBS News issued a statement tonight saying it is extremely pleased with that verdict. Galloway says he is considering an appeal.
In Central America tonight, three top American diplomats are on their way home from Nicaragua. The Sandinista government ordered them out of the country after accusing them of plotting to overthrow the government. Military officials laid out that charge during a news conference in Managua. They say the diplomats came up with a plan to recruit and train Nicaraguans to assassinate top officials of the government. They also showed radios and code books, which they say the diplomats gave to a double agent. The officials played a videotape which allegedly shows the double agent meeting with one of the diplomats. In Washington, the State Department is protesting the action. A spokesman calls the charges absurd.
Among other things, they suggested that these people were engaged in planning for assassination activities. We have rather consistently denied any such activities.
The White House tonight reportedly is considering several options for retaliation against the Nicaraguan government.
Carol, in Texas tonight, the U.S. Army is investigating an explosion that injured 26 soldiers, six of them seriously. 20 of the injured men were airlifted in Army helicopters to a hospital in El Paso. They were hurt by flying shrapnel when an anti-tank weapon blew up during a training demonstration at a military range north of the city. The weapon was a kind of rocket launcher. All the soldiers are new recruits who have only been in the Army for a few weeks. Their instructor took the brunt of the blast, and he is listed in very serious condition tonight.
In California, a little boy whose throat was slashed during the murders of his parents is helping police tonight in a massive manhunt for the killers. The boy is using sign language and notes to tell police what happened. Four people died in the house just 5 miles from a state prison where two inmates escaped over the weekend. Police believe the inmates may have been involved. The boy, his parents, his sister, and a neighbor boy were herded into a bedroom and stabbed repeatedly. Whoever did it took nothing from the house except the family car. Officials in Mexico tonight are filing murder charges against the Puerto Rican terrorist, William Morales. He was captured last month after a gun battle with Mexican police in which three people were killed. The United States is trying to extradite him to this country. He is responsible for a 1975 bombing in New York that killed four people and for a number of bombings here in Chicago.
Chicago Alderman Ed Vidoliak is calling it the latest smear against him. He's talking about a Sun-Times report that a city insurance contract was given to a firm with ties to organized crime. The paper also says that Vidoliak recommended the company which got that contract, and that company rents space in a building owned by Vidoliak. Today, 43rd Ward Alderman Martin Oberman called for an investigation.
I suspect that we will never know all of the deals that were entered into in the Byrne era. But we know who the players were during that era, and we know who has a stake in keeping control of the situation.
Normally, the City Council Finance Committee would conduct such an investigation, but Oberman wants a special panel since the disputed chairman of the Finance Committee, Ed Burke, is a Vidoliak ally.
Five Chicago elementary schools targeted for closing are being given new life tonight, at least temporarily. 15 schools were originally scheduled for closing as part of a plan to save the school system $6 million. But in response to angry parents and teachers, the School Site Reduction Committee is recommending five of those schools be saved.
The schools are Pope Elementary on South Albany, Gregory Elementary on West Polk, Anthony on South Torrance, Nettlehurst on North Broadway, and Fernwood on South Union. In most cases, the committee said, children would have to walk too far through seedy parts of town and across dangerous streets to get to other schools if their neighborhood schools are closed. but the site reduction committee still recommends 10 schools be closed or partially closed. The full board will vote on these recommendations on Wednesday. School Superintendent Ruth Love tonight said she doesn't know the details of the new plan, but wonders if the school system can afford it.
I think you have to ask the board members. They must have an alternative plan for getting the money.
They don't. They just said the children's interests should come before financial interests.
Good, then I hope they're raising the money.
Ruth Love's reaction to the news comes as no surprise. The committee's decision came at the same time she was announcing a massive drive to save the Chicago public schools from financial ruin. The drive is being led by a coalition of school, business, labor, and community leaders. They will begin a lobbying effort to get more money from the state legislature, including a plan to raise property taxes.
If the Illinois General Assembly doesn't get its act together, and soon, the Chicago public schools will be devastated. They'll be in shambles.
Part of the money for Chicago schools could come with Governor Thompson's $1.6 billion tax package. But the Save Our Schools Coalition today made it clear it is not happy with lawmakers in Springfield. And it will, in Ruth Love's words, keep the record about those who don't vote with us.
Carol, the worst of the flooding may not be over for residents in Utah. We'll have that story and more news in just a minute.
Go to Midas on our honeymoon, but we didn't have much choice. The brakes on my old Camaro were making a terrible noise, so we pulled into Midas and showed them my guarantee.
And now you're a Pat Fitzsimmons?
I am. Used to be. Midas fixed the brakes right away, and because of the guarantee, the brake shoes were free. I guess something always goes wrong on your wedding day. It's a good thing we could go to Midas.
Trust the Midas touch.
Don't be lured by Commodore and TI's low-priced computer keyboards. You're not getting the whole picture. If you want a complete home computer system, the price will pile up fast.
Introducing the Aquarius home computer system from Mattel Electronics, a complete system for a lot less.
It comes with all this and an amazing feature no one else has, a 13-inch color TV for just $99. Buy the Aquarius system by June 20th. We'll send you a $300 color TV for $99.
The Supreme Court tonight is with upholding the windfall profits tax on oil, which means the government can continue to collect billions of dollars from oil companies. The unanimous ruling overturns an earlier decision that the tax was unconstitutional. The tax was imposed to capture some of the profits that oil companies gained when price controls were lifted back in 1981. House Speaker Tip O'Neill tonight has an alternative to the president's 10% tax cut slated for July. He says that it's time now for the rich to pay.
The beneficiaries of the Reagan economic program have been the most wealthy in this country. As the beneficiaries of the Reagan economic program, the financially well must be asked to sacrifice in the effort to reduce the deficit.
The O'Neill plan sets a $700 limit on the tax cut for anyone making $50,000 or more. O'Neill also says the government could save $13 billion by 1985. At the White House, the president was asked to respond and spell out an answer to O'Neill's plan.
No, but I'll give you my autograph on a veto bill.
But the Senate Republican leader, Howard Baker, says the president won't have to veto O'Neill's plan. Baker predicts it won't ever pass through Congress.
There's a gloomy forecast for the economy tonight from President Reagan's chief economic advisor. It includes high unemployment for several years and inevitable tax increases. Advisor Martin Feldstein says the economy is recovering, but the recovery cannot last if big federal deficits continue. The mountains of Utah are holding a gloomy forecast for the people down in the valleys. Hotter weather expected later this week will bring a new surge of floodwaters from the melted snow. And today, officials sent out an urgent call for volunteers to build up their sandbag levees. The streams going into Salt Lake City are rising again above flood stage. Today, police directed traffic over makeshift earthen dams to avoid tie-ups. In nearby Farmington, hit hard over the past week, people are now trying to salvage anything they can find. Officials in that area are also warning residents that when the temperatures hit the 90s in a few days, it could be too late. There's big news tonight for the future of Times Beach, Missouri, which is reeling from the discovery of deadly dioxin throughout the town. Officials there have voted for the town to take over ownership of all the properties. That now clears the way for the federal government to buy out Times Beach, apparently at a price of $33 million. It would be the first buyout ever of a whole town because of hazardous waste. The buyout had been stymied for months because of disagreements over who would take title to the contaminated town.
Closer to home, some Chicago residents are fighting mad about plans for a waste site in the South Deering neighborhood. I.J. Hudson has that story.
They call themselves iron dealers to abolish the chemical threat. The small community of South Deering was once known as Irondale, and these people don't want a landfill in their area.
Enough is enough! No more dump! Enough is enough!
Waste Management Incorporated, the company that plans to put a dump in their community, also owns this site at 138th Street and the Calumet Expressway. Blocking the main entrance of the facility was the group's way of getting media coverage and of trying to force a meeting with waste management officials. The demonstrators claim the 280-acre dump would be within three blocks of a school. Company officials say they have suggested a meeting between a small group from each side, but have been turned down. That the company is willing to talk, but not on a confrontational basis. The site is a busy one, and traffic backed up in a hurry. Police tried to mediate the dispute and arrange a meeting, but that only brought more chants.
No more dump! Enough is enough! No more dump! Enough is enough!
We want a meeting with the president of this company, Dean Bunkrock. If he doesn't come out for a meeting, we'll come back again. We'll come back again and again. We'll keep coming back until they withdraw their application.
40 minutes after the demonstration began, it was over. No injuries, no arrests, and no meeting. I.J. Hudson, Channel 2 News.
Sunshine will return to Chicago tomorrow. Harry Volkman will have a complete forecast when we come back.
Right from the start, Amoco Premium Lead-Free gives this Saab 900 Turbo faster acceleration. It's the highest octane lead-free you can buy, and it's the same high-performance gasoline that helps stop engine run-on in this 79 compact. Whether you're driving a four-year-old compact or a high-performance car, you expect more from Amoco. And premium performance is one way you get it.
Important calls will always get through.
Esther, hold on. I have another call waiting. Hello?
Hello, Mom. It's a boy.
To get call waiting, call Illinois Bell at 1-800-535-6000.
For the father who worked all those late nights that you tried so hard to wait up to see, give him something comfortable to come home to. His own recliner from Marshall Fields. Save 20 to 50% on Marshall Fields' entire selection of recliners. From Barca Lounger, Lane, and Strata Lounger. A wonderful selection of coverings. A wonderful gift for any father to come home to. Now at 20 to 50% savings. And just in time for Father's Day at Marshall Fields.
The day comes slowly to God's country. Nature can't be rushed. Brewing a beer nature's way can't be rushed either. It's called croisening. The most natural way to brew beer and the most expensive. Which is why only Old Style has such a clean, crisp taste. A taste no other beer can match. Heilemann's Old Style. Pure brewed in God's country. Slowly and naturally.
Arthur Green says you can't take it with you, so he might as well spend the $2 million he's won in the Illinois lottery. Green, a retired machine repairman in Rockford, this week became the second biggest winner of the lotto game. He'll get $100,000 a year for 20 years. Green says he'll take his family on a vacation and set up trusts for his grandchildren. How about that, Harry? Hope tomorrow's a winner.
Well, tomorrow's going to be a nice day, and I hope to be a grandfather in a few weeks myself.
But at any rate,
I better buy a lottery ticket. We've got tonight some fair weather, low 48 degrees, and then tomorrow for Tuesday, sunny and a high of 72. It's pretty cool with John Coughlin over in the Scandinavian area. It's only in the 40s over there tonight. As we take a look at the map for this evening, we see a northwest flow. That means cool air from Canada. One big long front from Maine all the way down to Texas. This front has been very active in the south today with tornadoes, heavy winds, and hail in many South Texas cities from just south of San Antonio. There's a suburb down called Los Angeles, Texas, which has been hit with tornadic winds, and down through Alice, Cotulla, Nacogdoches, Brownwood, over to Uvalde earlier. Meantime, we're cool with the low humidity and only a slight chance of a few clouds and no rain for several days. 110 in Palm Springs today and 101 out in Phoenix, Arizona. Son of Drummond's favorite friends live in Palm Springs. Anyway, what we got here tonight on this satellite view shows the clouds that are swirling around a Canadian low, and then meantime, the rains with that front that I talked about all over here. They're so white because they're cold, as they don't radiate a lot of heat. Now the radar nationally shows also the echoes of the raindrops, and there are yellows and reds in there where you've got the heavy rains. The light to moderate ones are in the blue shades. Notice all this clear weather around here because no clouds have drops in them big enough to return an echo to the screen, the receiver. There will be sun tomorrow here and rain on the coast and in the far west in the plateau region, not too welcome in the high hills around Salt Lake City, Farmington, and those areas around there. But we'll be in the sun, and that'll be good for several days. Let's take a look now at this map for temperatures. Note that the hundreds continue in the far southwest, and the 50s if you're going up to Sault Ste. Marie, Michigan. But we'll be in the low to middle 70s tomorrow, and then up close to 80 by Wednesday and Thursday. Tonight's temperatures are mostly in the upper 50s to low 60s around the region, and we have winds tomorrow from the northwest at 10 to 15. Not a bad day for spraying, painting, washing outside, picnicking, golfing, whatever. Now let's take a look at what we had today. The high was, this afternoon, 68, the low 52. Now, it ought to be about 78 at this time of year, and it was 97 in 1971 and 40 degrees just a year ago today, the record low. Sun up at 5:16 and sun down 8:23. The sun won't rise any earlier than that. O'Hare 54, Lakefront 63, and Midway 59 now, humidity 54, and wind southwest 8, pressure low and steady. Tonight, clear and cool, low 48 degrees. A beautiful evening out there in the windy city of Chicago. That's not very windy tonight. Sunny and mild, a high 72 tomorrow. Winds northwest 10 to 15. And then the next day, Wednesday, sunny and warmer, high 76. Completing the five-day forecast for Thursday, Friday, and Saturday, we see some pretty fine conditions with readings in the lower 70s to upper 60s. That's ideal living weather, John and Carol.
You said it. You said it.
Looks great, Harry. Thank you. Doctors at a clinic in Highland Park are testing a new machine tonight that could eventually replace ultrasound, angiograms, and other body scanning techniques. It's called the Nuclear Magnetic Resonance Machine, or NMR. Health and Science editor Roger Field has more.
Doctors at the Greenberg Radiology Clinic made their first NMR scans of the skull of their first patient in just 4.5 minutes. It works by creating a strong magnetic field around the head, then bombarding the patient with radio waves. There are no x-rays involved. A computer creates the picture.
This is the skull. This is the fat around the skull.
Yeah, it's fat around, right.
And these are the eyeballs?
That's correct. The orbits and the eyeballs, correct.
And this is the brain stem?
Brain stem, correct.
And that's then doctors tried for their first cross-section the long way, the so-called sagittal view. There are only about a dozen nuclear magnetic resonance machines in the world so far. Unlike x-rays, they don't show up bones at all. NMR is very good at showing fat, muscles, nerves, and fluid. Keep in mind, this is still very much a research tool. Eventually, it could replace angiograms, ultrasound, nuclear cameras, even mammograms. But it's too early to tell that, and it may replace nothing. Just extend the physician's ability to see and diagnose a bit better. For this first patient, the Highland NMR machine meant peace of mind. Magnificently, we see your actual brain stem, called the pons and the medulla, and your spinal cord to this level. Mm-hmm. Okay, so far,
This looks completely normal. The images we've taken look completely normal.
Are you glad to hear that they haven't found anything yet so far?
Some of the options to be considered. I'm delighted to know I don't have them.
Just what test equipment this machine will replace has yet to be seen, but it is almost certain to mean faster, more complete diagnoses earlier for many tricky diseases. Roger Field, Channel 2 News.
There is another item of note tonight from the world of science. This one involves trees. Most plant lovers will tell you that if you talk to your plants, they will respond. Well, scientists at Dartmouth say that trees may actually talk to each other. According to their theory, when a tree is attacked by insects or other little pests, it sounds out a chemical scent warning other trees in the area. The other trees then change their chemical makeup so they aren't quite so tasty when the bugs attack them. Keep in mind, this is all just a theory, but if it holds up, it could give the saying about communicating with nature a whole new meaning.
Blitz highlights and word of a new coach for the Bulls. Kevin Lynn will have details when we come back.
Disappointment when you find you're not booked on your favorite airline. British Airways fly more people to more countries than anyone else. It's the world's favorite airline.
Get ready, Chicagoland, for your Better Buick dealer's greatest front-wheel drive sale ever. Until June 25th, you can enter the world of Buick front-wheel drive for as little as $69.58. For sophisticated engineering, for style, for luxury, Buick has the deals and the cars that take on the imports. Century, Skylark, Skyhawk. And now get 8.8% financing on Skylark and Skyhawk until June 30th. See your Chicagoland, Northern Indiana Better Buick dealer today.
A summer sale with all of the brilliance and colors of summer. A summer sale with all of the excitement and freshness of a summer shower. A summer sale that makes you feel good all over. Best of all, you can save 25 to 50% and more. Webull's June Buyer Sale, going on now. Share the summer feeling with us.
100 years old and we're still brand new. Come in and see what Webull's has for you.
One American institution will grace another this Sunday in Washington. The Beach Boys will play the White House by invitation of the President and Mrs. Reagan. It's a real vindication for the Beach Boys, who became the center of a controversy earlier this year with Interior Secretary James Watt. Watt banned all rock groups from a July 4th concert, declaring them unpatriotic. But politicians, from the president on down, rallied round the Beach Boys, calling them as American as apple pie and forcing Watt to apologize. The benefit at the White House Sunday will support the Special Olympics. I'll tell you one outfit that doesn't have to apologize tonight, and that would be the Chicago Blitz. Am I right on that?
Well, no, unfortunately, they probably do have a few apologies to make.
But
before we get started, Carol, I want to congratulate you on your Emmy.
Thank you.
Now she won't mind if I take a little few extra seconds. Anyway, the top story, of course, today is that Kevin Lockery is coming to Chicago, and he will coach the Bulls. Today, from his home in Atlanta, Lockery announced he will leave the Hawks and come to the Bulls to team up with his good friend, the Bulls general manager, Rod Thorne. And the Bulls have reportedly agreed to give up their second choice in this year's NBA draft. That goes to the Hawks as compensation for signing Lockery. Word is that Lockery will sign a deal which will make him one of the top two money-making coaches in the NBA. The important issue is that Lockery is a good, solid NBA coach. He gets along with Thorne. He should be in Chicago tomorrow to sign his contract. And the guy has plenty of work to do to earn his money. I wish him luck. It was a long night in Boston for the Blitz tonight in the USFL. The Blitz dominated the Breakers in yards gained and first downs. They also dominated in penalties and turnovers, and the Breakers beat the Blitz tonight 21-15. The Blitz folded again in the fourth quarter, and their record is now 9-5. Things started well enough. The Blitz was leading 3-0 in the second quarter when Tim Cagle hit Trumaine Johnson. Johnson fell down here on the play, But no one held him down. He got up and scored, and the blitz led 10-0. But the Breakers scored on a John Walton keeper in the second, and here in the third, with the score 13-7, Walton went 50 yards on the flea flicker to Nolan France. The play carried all the way to the blitz 6-yard line. Next play, and the Breakers went ahead for good. Richard Crump banged over from the six. The Breakers went on to take the lead 14-13. After that, the blitz turned the ball over repeatedly in between penalties. They lost 21-15. They are now 9-5 and a game behind Tampa Bay in the useful standings. In baseball, the Brewers have made a major deal. They have sent their home run king, Gorman Thomas, and two pitchers. They will go to the Indians in exchange for outfielder Rick Manning and pitcher Rick Waits. Thomas was the key guy in the trade. He'd averaged 35 homers and 95 RBIs a year for 5 years. Last year in the playoffs, he went dry with one homer in the championship series and no homers in the World Series. This year, Thomas is hitting only 183 with 5 home runs in 26 games. He's gone to the Indians for Rick Manning. Here are the scores tonight. No National League scores. They had the night off. American League scores, Milwaukee over California 9-7. Oakland and Cleveland were rained out. Baltimore over Toronto 8-1, so Baltimore's back at number one in the American League East. Detroit over Boston 11-6, and the Yankees finally beat Seattle. The score was 6-2. In high school baseball, the boys are down to the state tournament in Springfield. Among the teams to qualify today, who else? The high school sports powerhouse, New Trier, is going. Today they shut out Fenwick 5-0, and they'll make the trip. At Niles West, New Trier got enough to win on this play in the second inning. Jason Murphy lined a single to left. Chris Beacom came in to score, and the Trevians of New Trier had enough to win it right there with a 1-0 lead. Still in the second, Garth Blake hit a chopper. The run scored. Blake beat out the hit at first. That made a 2-0 New Trier in the second inning. As it turned out, it was just insurance. The reason was that fellow, the pitcher Art Paponis. He gets the last out on a strikeout here, and New Trier beat Fenwick 5-0. Next, it is on to Springfield in the state tournament for the ever-powerful, all-powerful Trevians. Other baseball winners today were Brother Rice, Waukegan West, and Joliet West. On the girls' side, the sectional winners included Maine South, Loves Park Harlem, Rich Central, and Revis. Now, yesterday was the windup of the U.S. Gymnastics Championships at the UIC Pavilion. Mitch Gaylord was the all-around men's champion. Someone you should know was the best in the women. Diane Durham of Gary, Indiana, is the little lady in question. Harry Porterfield told us about her years ago when she was 9. Jeannie Morris talked with her this past week. And yesterday, at the ripe old age of 14, Diane Durham won the vault. She won the balance beam. She won the floor exercise. Here in the uneven parallel bars, Diane finished only second. But the totals were good enough to make Diane Durham the all-around women's champ at the U.S. Nationals. She is the best in America, and she's probably someone all of us should know. And in hockey, two Hawks have made the NHL's All-Star team this year. Steve Larmer was the all-rookie first team. He made the all-rookie first team as a right winger. He set the all-time Hawks rookie scoring record, 43 goals, 47 assists. Dennis Savard is number 18 in these highlights. Denny was second team all-NHL because the first team center is none other than the great Wayne Gretzky of Edmonton. Denny was pretty great for Chicago despite his dancing after goals. He had 35 goals and 86 assists in 78 games. In the playoffs, he had 8 goals and 9 assists. Dennis Savard is second team All-NHL for 1982 and 1983. And that's it in sports on Emmy night.
Thank you, Kevin. Regular troops will be back in the trenches at 5, 6, and 10 tomorrow. So long for now. Thanks, everybody.
Good night.
Jockey. A commitment to quality and value.
The next time you turn on your radio, turn to 94 FM for today's easy listening on the new WLAK.
Aldi has 20 pounds of charcoal for $1.99.
Stocking up is smart.
Aldi.
The stock-up store.
Three tough questions. Ask them all when you buy furniture. When you get your furniture home, if you're not happy with it, will they take it back? Wix will. If you can find the identical item for less elsewhere within 30 days, will they refund the difference? Wix will. Will they give you a written warranty against defects in workmanship good for 5 full years? Wix will. Sure. They call me the toughest retailer in America, but you've got to be tough too. Ask tough questions. Get the right answers.
Looking for a powerful home computer? This is the one. Texas Instruments home computer. With 16K memory, it can take you a long way. Want a computer with a lot of software? Oh, yeah, this is the one. The TI home computer gives you more of these software cartridges than any computer in the world. The whole world. So, with all the power you have here to run all the power here, this is the one. The home computer from Texas Instruments. This is the one.
Channel 2, WBBM-TV, Chicago. Due to the following special broadcast of MASH, the CBS late movie will be seen in 1/2 hour.